Yeah, so I think the last question is left for of the exercise of the chapter in fact.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, question 35 is 34th we have done. Just
Yes,
one
sir.
question left. Then we are going to start with the new chapter. Okay, so almost have understood the chapter. We will start next. Understood.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
Good morning. So exercise 7B, last question, question number 35. Before starting the question, let me tell you what is the meaning of 15% solution of something, whatever it is. Meaning of 15% solution, 20% solution, 25% solution. Whatever it is, what is the meaning of this? So, if there is a solution of alcohol, okay, like in the question, it is given this, there is a 15% solution of alcohol. So, if suppose I have 100 ml of alcohol solution, 100% of solution, sorry, 100 ml of solution I have, and it is a 15% solution. Of alcohol, 15% solution of alcohol. क्या बोला मुझे? एक example ले रहा हूँ. This is only an example, just to explain what is the meaning of 15% solution. This is a 15% solution. Okay, so 100 ml I have, total 100 ml is there. 15% solution means it has 15 ml of pure alcohol. Fifteen ml of pure alcohol is there, and the remaining 85 ml is something else. This could be water or any other ingredient could be there. So 85%, it could be sugar, water, or anything else, whatever it is, could be anything else. So 85 ml is something else, and 15 ml is alcohol. Okay, so this is the meaning of 15%, sorry. What is the meaning of 20% solution? Just suppose if I have
So it means there is 20 ml
there
pure alcohol.
20 ml pure alcohol and 80% other things.
Let us assume that I have. Let us assume that I have 200 ml of solution. 200 ml solution is there, and the solution is of 20%. Suppose, no, sorry, 30% solution is there. 30% solution is there. The solution is 30% solution, and total quantity is 200 ml. So, can you tell me what is the quantity of pure alcohol in this?
200 into 100 maybe यही हो
What is the quantity of pure alcohol in this? This is the 30% solution, and the total quantity of the solution
सर
is
30
15.
अपॉन 100 इनटू 200
15% 15%
50% of
15
How will you calculate this? This is simple. 30% of 200 ऐसे तो निकालोगे. 30%
30 अपॉन 100 इनटू 200
is pure alcohol. Correct or not?
यस सर
So what you will get 60 ml.
सिक्स
So this is 60 ml is pure alcohol.
Sir,
60 by 100 and into 200, then we will get the answer. Means 13 upon.
this is just an example, all of you. I am explaining what is the meaning of 15% solution, 30% solution, whatever the solution is, what is the meaning of it, first of all? This I am telling you.
Excuse me, sir.
I have taken an example. Yes.
Sir, if we have to take the percentage, we will keep 200 on top upon 100 into 30.
Like this. 30% of 200 is 30 upon 100 into 200.
Okay, sir.
Can you simplify this? 360.
Okay.
So, I asked you that if it is a 30% solution and the total quantity of the solution is 200 ml, can you tell me how much pure alcohol is there in the solution? How will you find out? 30% of 200 is pure alcohol. That means 60 ml. So, if you calculate this, you will get 60 ml. So, 60 ml is pure alcohol. This is how you can calculate the quantity of pure alcohol in the solution. Okay. So this concept will be used in the question. Let us start doing the question. So how much question is, how much pure alcohol must be added to 400 ml of a 15% solution? 400 ml of a 15% solution to make the strength 32%. यहाँ पर strength को 15% से बढ़ा करके 32% बनाना है. कैसे बढ़ा सकते हैं strength, किसी solution की strength कैसे बढ़ाएंगे? If you add more pure alcohol in the solution, the strength will increase. उसमें percentage जो है वो increase हो जाएगा alcohol का. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
में अगर कोई को सोल्यूशन दिया जाए और मुझे उसमें अल्कोहल का परसेंटेज बढ़ाना है, यानी कि जो दो क्वांटिटीज है, एक तो अल्कोहल है और दूसरा जो आपका बाकी सब कुछ हो सकता है, टू बी वाटर एंड अदर इंग्रेडिएंट्स, तो उसमें मुझे अल्कोहल का कंटेंट अगर बढ़ाना है तो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल एड प्योर अल्कोहल इन द सोल्यूशन. उसमें परसेंटेज ऑफ अल्कोहल क्या होगा, इंक्रीज हो जाएगा. यस. सो नाउ इस क्वेश्चन में क्या करना है, मेरे पास 15% सॉल्यूशन था, उस 15% सॉल्यूशन में मुझे प्योर अल्कोहल ऐड करना है. कितना ऐड करना है ये मुझे फाइंड करना है, लेकिन फाइनली क्या बनाना है ये पता है मेरे को. क्या बनाना है? 32% प्योर अल्कोहल वाला सॉल्यूशन बनाना है. ओके, सो हाउ मच pure alcohol I have right now?
So 15%.
First of all, let
x.
The quantity of pure alcohol to be added B x and
x
ml we are going to add. So right now, how much pure alcohol is there in the given solution?
15%.
15%
of 400.
400. This is pure alcohol. Okay. पूरे अल्कोहल और ऐड करना है. कितना ऐड कर रहा हूँ? साफ साफ लिखा हुआ है x और ऐड करूंगा. x और ऐड कर दिया. 15% वाज ऑलरेडी देयर. 15% ऑफ 400 प्योर अल्कोहल वाज ऑलरेडी देयर. उसमें
32% 400 ml.
तो मेरे पास कितना प्योर अल्कोहल हो गया? 32% हो गया. तो 32% किसका? सिंपल सा लॉजिक है, इट इज वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. ऑलरेडी 15% अल्कोहल था मेरे पास. Very simple to understand. Already 15% alcohol था, उसने x ml और add कर दिया. अब मेरे पास 32% बन गया, लेकिन 32% किसका? 32% of what? 32% of
400 ml.
400 ml.
400 plus x.
X. 400 plus x. ये plus x क्यों आया? बिकॉज टोटल क्वांटिटी मेरे पास कितनी हो गई, 400 ml ऑलरेडी था स्टार्टिंग में ही था, सॉल्यूशन कितना था मेरे पास 400 ml था, उसमें x ml और ऐड करा है, सो टोटल क्वांटिटी नाउ हाउ मच टोटल क्वांटिटी इज देयर,
400 प्लस x,
400 प्लस x,
इसमें
एक्सक्यूज मी सर
कोल है प्योर एल्कोहल कितना परसेंट है, 32% है, तो 32% ऑफ टोटल क्वांटिटी इज प्योर एल्कोहल नाउ. यस
Sir, I am not able to understand why after equal sign we have written 32% of 400 plus x.
This is what I am telling you. अगर हम total solution की बात करें, 32% of total solution अब हमारे पास alcohol है ना, 32% of total solution. लेकिन total solution है कितना? Now how much? Because हमने इसमें x already add कर दिया, already हम पे 400 ml था. It is given in the question that how much quantity of solution we have, 400 ml already. उससे मैंने pure alcohol और add कर दिया, तो total solution कितना हो गया, 400 plus x हो गया, नहीं हो गया? What is the total solution?
Yes sir.
400 plus x. X और add किया ना अभी. देखिए. So total quantity of solution how much is there? 400 plus x. अब इसमें से कितना alcohol है? 32% alcohol. So this is your equation. Is the equation clear to everyone now?
Yes, sir. Answer is 100 ml.
Yeah, correct. 15 upon 100 of 400. Yani ki multiply plus x equals to 32 upon 100 multiplied by 400 plus x. Okay. So here you can put this 100 and the zeros of 400, 15 into 4 is 60, 60 plus x is equal to 32 upon 100 multiplied by 400 plus x. So I'm taking this 100 to LHS. Ye denominator mein,
it will be
60 plus x cross multiplying as into 100. Ye 100 ko main idhar le gaya. LHS RHS mein 32 into 400 plus x. There could be other ways of solving also. It is possible that you are solving it with some other method. No problem. Answer will be same. So 6000 plus 100x equals to 128 0, 0 plus 32x. This will be 100x minus 32x. Equals to 12,800 minus 6,000. 68x equals to 6,800. X equals to 100 ml. How much pure alcohol we have added in the solution? We have added 100 ml of pure alcohol in the solution.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, my equation was x plus 60 upon x plus 400 is equal to 32 upon 100, and then 32, then cross multiplication, 32 bracket x plus 400 is equal to x plus.
Your equation was
sir, x plus 60 upon x plus 400 is equal to 32 upon 100, then after cross multiplying 32 bracket x plus 400 is equal to 100 multiplied by bracket x plus 60.
Correct.
Sir, now we will do ratio and proportion.
Triangle.
We will do properties of triangles.
Okay, sir.
Sir, we can start simple sir. Interest.
No, beta, first we will do properties of triangles.
Okay, sir.
Again, in simple
Excuse
interest.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir, simple interest is a very easy chapter.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Navya.
See?
Sir, in the 26th question, we haven't, I mean, sir, we haven't done the 26th question. It is of percentage. You said you will tell us.
How we will do after doing the percentage?
Sir, we have done that. Sir, we have done that. Done.
No,
26th. No, sir, we have not done that.
Sir, in my notebook. 26th
one, I'll tell you that we will do it after doing profit and loss and percentage. It is a simple question. So if you know how to, you can do it, otherwise no problem. We will do it afterwards. Okay, so let's start the next chapter, which is properties of triangles.
Sir, which is chapter number?
Chapter number 15, page number 181.
Sir, in that what we have to do right now?
Nothing, I will tell you. No, you don't have to write anything. Just write the name of the chapter.
So which chapter we will start today?
Properties.
Was written properties of triangle.
Okay, all of you give your attendance in the chat box. Just write your name in the chat box, all of you, to give your attendance.
Sir, I've given my attendance.
Okay. Given.
I've also given.
Given.
Excuse me, sir.
Given.
Yes.
Sir, when will you tell our marks?
Yes, sir, maths.
Other teachers have to give the marks?
Sir.
No, sir, only Smriti, ma'am.
Only Smriti, ma'am.
But actually, I cannot tell you without the permission of the coordinator or the principal. They have not asked to give the marks. So that is why.
Sir, when will we get a report card?
Sir, you can tell how we have did in the test.
You all have done well. Not very, very well, but done well. I have more expectations from you. My expectations are a little higher.
Sir, how many got full?
Anya Agarwal. Yes,
sir, how many got full?
I think 2-3 have scored full. 2 or 3.
Sir, can you tell the name?
No, not right now. Most probably this week only you will get the report cards. I'm not 100% sure. Most probably this
week. How many have in 70 line?
But I don't remember like this, but many of you have scored more than 90% out of 100. Many of you have scored more than 90.
That means 50% class.
Sorry?
That means 50% class.
You know the percentage also.
Overall percentage.
Sir, in maths or including what subject?
No, only in maths I know. I don't know the marks of, although I have the marks, but I don't remember. I have all the marks.
Sir, please.
Sir, but how Smriti ma'am told the marks?
Because she is the coordinator. She is the coordinator. I am just a small, simple employee of the school. गरीब आदमी
सर यू आर आर क्लास टीचर
यस सर
मैं इस स्कूल का सबसे गरीब आदमी हूँ Okay, next chapter. Properties. Of triangles. So, let us first discuss about what are triangles. Triangles have three sides and three angles. Just name the sides of this triangle. I am making a triangle on the board. You have to just name the sides of the triangle. Name the sides.
Just killing.
Sir, PQ, QR, and RP.
Yeah.
Sir, PQ, QR, and RP.
QR, and RS.
PQ, QR, and R.
PQ, QR, and RP.
R and PR.
PQ is the first side,
QR
is the second side, and QR is the third side. The triangle has three sides, PQ, PR, and QR. These are the three sides of the triangle. There are three angles also. This is known as an angle. Angle kya hota hai? Jab ek side, dusre side ke respect mein kitni inclined hai, kitni teedhi hai, that is known as an angle. तो एक साइड के रेस्पेक्ट में ये दूसरी वाली साइड जो वो कितनी टेढ़ी है इसके रेस्पेक्ट में दैट इज एन एंगल सो दिस इज एंगल पी एंगल क्यू एंड एंगल आर देयर आर थ्री एंगल्स इन अ ट्रायंगल थ्री साइड्स थ्री एंगल्स नेम द थ्री एंगल्स ऑफ द ट्रायंगल
सर एंगल क्यू एंगल पी एंड एंगल आर
एंगल क्यू आर क्यू एंगल पी एंड पी
एंगल पी
एंड आर पी क्यू आर पी
हां देयर आर टू वेज ऑफ नेमिंग द एंगल्स एंगल पी You can simply call it as angle P, angle Q, and angle R. Okay. You can also name this angle as angle QPR, angle P.
Angle PQR, angle QRP, and angle RPQ.
QRP.
PQR.
Angle QRP.
Or इसको बुला सकते हैं angle PRQ या फिर PRQ. So this is these are the same thing. There are three angles in a triangle and three sides and also three vertices. What is the meaning of vertices?
Sir, the points at the end.
Yeah, the points at which two sides meet are known as vertices. Okay, so this is the first vertex. Vertex is singular form and vertices is the plural form. सिंगुलर फॉर्म में क्या बुलाते हैं वर्टेक्स बुलाते हैं सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट वर्टेक्स क्यू पी इज द सेकंड वर्टेक्स पॉइंट एट विच टू साइड्स मीट द कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स ओनली द पॉइंट्स वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पॉइंट्स एट विच टू साइड्स मीट आर नोन एज वर्टेसेस ओके सो देयर आर थ्री वर्टेसेस इन ट्रायंगल थ्री साइड्स थ्री एंगल्स एंड थ्री वर्टेसेस सो दिस इज अ ट्रायंगल नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट types of triangles on the basis of the sides. There are three types of triangle, isosceles triangles, equilateral triangle, and scalene triangle. Can you tell me what are isosceles triangles?
Sir, in which there is two same sides
and sides are equal. In which there are two sides and one different.
Triangles in which two sides are equal are known as isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC मैंने यहाँ बताया है. AB side से मेरे को AC की equal है. That is a triangle. Sides are equal. Please keep your mics on. Turn off your mics. Turn off your mics. Yeah. So in a triangle, when two sides are equal, when it is known as isosceles triangle. There is another type of triangle which is known as equilateral triangle. Sabhi ko yaad hoga. दो जगह कट लगाया दो साइड पे, तो दो साइड पे कट लगाने का मतलब क्या है? दैट दीस टू साइड्स आर इक्वल. कट लगाने का मतलब क्या है? ऑल द थ्री साइड्स आर इक्वल.
ऑल साइड्स आर इक्वल.
एंड हियर देयर इज नो कट. Isosceles, equilateral, and scalene. Three types of triangles are there on the basis of the length of the sides. And on the basis of measure of the angles also we can have different types of angles, like the first one is acute
angle. Right angle.
Yeah, right angle.
Acute angle, right angle, and obtuse angle.
Acute angle triangles are those. Do I have to make the figure for this or just orally?
No, sir. No, sir. Explain it only.
No, sir.
Explain it only.
First is your acute angle triangles. Acute angle triangles are those in which
less than 90 degrees.
Angles are less than 90. All the
less than 90 degrees.
Less than 90. Then it is an acute angle triangle. If the next one is obtuse angle triangle, if any one angle is more than 90, then it is known as obtuse angle triangle.
Obtuse.
Can you have two angles more than 90 in a triangle?
No, sir. No, sir.
We can not have, we can never ever have two angles more than 90 degrees in a triangle. Only one angle could be more than 90. The other two will be less than 90. If one angle is more than 90, the other two will be less than 90 only. But the name of the triangle is, still it is called as obtuse angle triangle. Like this. See in this figure. I have made this triangle. This angle is suppose 110 degrees. This is 40 degrees. And this one is 30 degrees. So you can see that only one angle is more than 90. This one. This is the angle which is more than 90. And the other two angles are less than 90. So what is the name of the triangle? It is known as obtuse angle triangle. It is known as obtuse angle triangle because one angle is obtuse. Ek angle obtuse hota hai, baaki dono kya hote hai? Acute hote hai. Still the name of the triangle is obtuse angle triangle. What are right angle triangles? A triangle in which only one angle.
Sir, which
triangle is 90 degrees.
Yeah, one angle is 90 degrees. The other two are less than 90. Suppose this is 50, the other is 40. Okay, so this is your triangle in which one angle is 90 degrees. So this type of triangle is known as right angle triangle. Got it? Very easy to identify.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So these are types of triangles on the basis of angles. So three types of triangles are there: acute angle triangles, obtuse angle triangles, and finally right angle triangles. Now, the next thing which is very important for all, you will write down the heading angle sum property of a triangle. Write down the heading in your copies. Angle sum property of triangles. Angle sum property of triangle.
So the angle sum property of triangle is that all the sum of all angles of a triangle is 180.
Yeah. So what is the property? The theorem is, this is known as a theorem. थ्योरम क्या होती है, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अ थ्योरम? किसी को पता है व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ थ्योरम?
सर थ्योरी?
नो नॉट थ्योरी, थ्योरम. द मीनिंग ऑफ थ्योरम, इट इज अ मैथमेटिकल टर्म जनरली यूज्ड इन मैथमेटिक्स, नॉट अ मैथमेटिकल टर्म. दिस टर्म इज जनरली यूज्ड इन मैथमेटिक्स, इन ज्योमेट्री स्पेशली. सो व्हाट इज अ थ्योरम?
Sir, there are formulas. For example, the sine theta, cos theta. Sir, we have to learn that.
Theorems are facts which.
Sir. Sir, can I tell?
Are verified, used anywhere in mathematics. So, ऐसे facts जिनको आप अगर एक बार prove कर लें, फिर आप उनको directly questions में उनका use कर सकते हैं. इनको हम क्या बुलाते हैं? Theorems बुलाते हैं. Understood the meaning of theorem?
Sir, yes, we have sir. To write this in our copy.
Yeah, I will. No, not the meaning of theorem. I will tell you what is the theorem in this case. Theorem kya keh rahi hai? What is theorem? Mein ek statement hota hai. Wo statement jo hota hai, aapko agar prove kar lete hain aap usko statement mein jo keh rahe hain. Abhi sikhata hu main aapko. Tension mat lijiye. परेशान मत होइएगा बिल्कुल भी. तो थ्योरम में स्टेटमेंट क्या लिखेंगे आप यहाँ पर? द स्टेटमेंट इज द सम ऑफ ऑल एंगल्स ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल इज 180 डिग्रीज. The sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Now this is known as the statement of the theorem. Theorem mein statement hai. This is known as the statement of the theorem. Har ek alag property mein ek alag statement alag statement ho sakta hai. Hota hai. Alag alag properties mein alag alag statements hote hain. So in this property, the theorem is the sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. तो इस स्टेटमेंट को अगर मैं प्रूव करके दिखा देता हूं, ध्यान से सुनिएगा. इफ आई प्रूव दिस स्टेटमेंट, व्हाटएवर इज गिवन इन द स्टेटमेंट, इफ आई प्रूव इट, देन आई कैन यूज दिस प्रॉपर्टी डायरेक्टली इन द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अ थ्योरम. ये मीनिंग होता है थ्योरम में, जो भी स्टेटमेंट है अगर मैं उसको प्रूव कर लेता हूँ, देन आई कैन यूज दैट प्रॉपर्टी डायरेक्टली इन द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, so what are we going to do next? We are going to prove that ye jo baat inhone boli hai wo ekdam sach baat hai. Let's start doing it. So you will have to draw a figure for this. Write down the heading proof. This is the statement of the theorem. Now we are going to prove the theorem. Proof ka matlab kya hota hai ki ab hum is baat ko sabit karne ke liye saboot pesh kar rahe hain. डिटेक्टिव बन गए आप सब लोग. यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू प्रूव दिस केस. ये जो यहाँ पर है केस, इस केस को मैं प्रूव करके दिखाऊंगा, साबित करके दिखाऊंगा कि मेरी बात एकदम सच है. सो यू आर गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द प्रूफ इन फ्रंट ऑफ द जज.
लेट्स टेल यू एनी ट्रायंगल वी कैन शो.
सॉरी बेटा,
so you draw any triangle we show you.
Yeah. What we have to do now, you are going to draw a triangle. In this triangle, this is a triangle ABC. You can name the triangle as ABC.
So you had geometry box, sir, which you used for board.
Sorry beta. Draw any triangle, draw a scalene triangle. And now what we have to prove in this, we have to prove that. Kya prove karna hai aapko? Likh lijiye.
Sir, angles and property.
So prove kya hai? Humko ye baat prove karke dikhani hai ki angle A plus angle B plus angle C, the sum of all the three angles is equal to 180 degrees. अब हम इसको प्रूव करके देखते हैं. स्टार्ट करते हैं. So before proving it, we will have to do a construction also. Construction. You are in class 7. You are doing this for the first time. When you will come to class 9, this will be a regular thing for you all. Proving theorems. आपके लिए एक regular बात हो जाएगी. 9th में आते आते. You have to prove many, many questions in that. Many, many theorems in class 9. So first time you are doing it in your life. Construction kya karna hai ab humko yahan par? Construction kya karenge? Draw a line EF passing through EF, draw EF parallel to BC passing through A. EF bula le, XY bula le, kuch bhi bula sakte.
PQ.
In your maths registers only you have to write down. All this is to be done in your maths pair registers. Draw PQ parallel to BC passing through A. क्या कर रहे हैं हम यहाँ पर वही construction जो मैंने यहाँ पर
बोला था. Excuse me sir, in all these questions we have to construct a triangle.
Not in all the questions. This is not a question. This is a theorem. First of all, this is given.
So what? Thanks, sir. If you are parallel, so then it would not be a triangle.
बेटा मीटिंग खत्म होने वाली मुझे लग नहीं रहा आज ये थ्योरम हो पाएगी.
तो सर कल कर लेंगे.
बेटा ट्राइंगल्स यू हैव टू मेक फिगर्स ओनली इन द क्वेश्चन व्हेन आई टेल यू टू मेक, नॉट इन ऑल. इन दिस वन यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द ट्राइंगल एंड नोट डाउन एज इट इज. Okay, so what is the construction? I have written the construction PQ parallel to BC. Draw PQ parallel to BC passing through A. So you have to make a line. Draw a line PQ which is parallel to BC and passing through A. So ye maine ek line banayi hai PQ. I have named the line as PQ. It is parallel to BC. And it is passing through point A.
So you make the dotted line.
मैंने dotted बनाई है देखिए. Parallel का symbol क्या होता है? If you make arrows like this on both the lines, that means PQ.